Hi, we are going to see the continuation of the last session. Now we are going to see the circuit elements in parallel. If you see three elements which is connected in parallel, the voltage across the elements is same, which means this element is having the potential difference V, this element also having the potential difference V, this also having the potential difference V. So the potential difference across every element is same because it is connected in parallel. But the current which is passing through each element, each and every element is different. So the current is dividing here. So I is coming through the node, then it is dividing here as I1, then it is passing here. Again it is dividing as I2 here, then it which is passing here is I3. We are just considering as a this is element 1, so this current is I1, so this is element 2, so this current is I2. Similarly, we are taking as I3. So the current passing through each and every element is I1, I2, I3, like that. So if you take I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Whereas if you see in the serial element, the current passing through every element is same. The voltage across each and every element is different. Here the current is same. Here the current is different, voltage is same. So just I equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. If you substitute the I value here, V by R1, then V by R2, V by R3. V is common. If you take V common out, then you will be getting this value 1 by R equivalent. So this will be equivalent to 1 by R equivalent. So this value is equal to 1 by R equivalent. This is the value of the equivalent resistance if you want to find out the elements which is connected in parallel. So if several resistors are connected in parallel, then one by r equivalent equal to 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2. If you are calculating it for the two resistance, then you can write like this. You can take the LCM and then you will be getting this is 1 by R equivalent. If you want to find out the R equivalent, just have to do inverse operation, then you will be getting this answer. So we can see the problem in this. Obtain the equivalent resistance of 2 60 ohm resistors in parallel and 3 60 ohm resistors in parallel. So here they have asked you to find out the equivalent resistance value for two resistors where each resistor value is 60 ohm. So you know the formula. If it is parallel, then you can go with this formula. Either you can write this formula or you can write this formula, any formula you can use it. So if you try with R equivalent, then R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So R equivalent is equal to, if you write R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2, R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. R1 and R2 are same here, so I am writing 60 only, so you are getting the answer of 30 ohm. You can write like this also, or you can write like this. This is the formula. Second one is, first question is 2 60 ohm resistor. Second question is 3 60 ohm resistor. If you want to write 3 60 ohm resistor, first method is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2, which means the simplified formula of R equivalent. Here it is not simplified. Directly we are writing 1 by R equivalent. So 1 by 60 plus 1 by 60 plus 1 by 60. So 3 times of 1 by 60. So I have written 1 by 60 one time. So there are 3 times. So just I am multiplying with 3. I am getting 0.05, which is equal to R equivalent. Means 1 by R equivalent equal to 0.05. If I want R equivalent, I need to inverse this value. If I do 1 by 0.05, then I am getting 20 ohm. You can do as like your wish, how you do you want to do. So next is voltage division. So there are one formula for the voltage divider rule. We have seen if the elements or if the resistors is connected in series, we are getting the voltages like this. we have seen how this element is connected, elements are connected in serial. So we have found V1 is equal to I into R1 because I is common in the serial connection. So V2 is equal to I into R2 like that. If you want to find out the individual voltage across this resistor, then you can write like this. V1 equal to I into R1. If you want to find the total voltage, V is equal to I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is what we have seen. Circuit elements connected in serial, we have seen V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Here V is equal to I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is what we have. So that same we are seeing here. So V1 equal to I into R1. V is equal to I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. If you want to find out the individual voltage of the resistor V1, then you can write like this. So V1 by V means you can just divide this two equation. V1 by V is equal to IR1 divided by I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. This II will get cancelled. So you will be getting V1 by V is equal to R1 divided by this value, R1 plus R2 plus R3. Then if you just cross multiply this V, then you will be getting V1 equal to V into R1 by R1 plus R2 plus R3. So if you want to find out the individual individual voltage of this resistance, then you can directly use this formula. It may be a n resistor, then you can write V1 equal to V into R1 by R1 plus R2 plus R3. If you want to find out V2, then you can write V into R2 by R1 plus R2 plus R3. Similarly, you have current division formula. This is from the parallel circuit which we have seen. So in parallel circuit, I is equal to V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3, because I equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. This is current division. So if you take I1 equal to V by R1. If you want to find out the individual current from which is flowing through the resistor R1, then you can do like this. Like I1 by I, if you divide I1 by I, which is equal to I1 is 1 by R1 divided by I is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This V and this V will get cancelled if you divide this. Then if you will do simplification of this one, then you will be getting R2 R3 divided by R1 R2 plus R1 R3 plus R2 R3. Then if you want to find out I1, then you have to cross multiply I into this value. This is for 3 resistor. If it is for 2 resistor, then you have to write like this. So we can do some problem. Find the equivalent resistance for the circuit shown in the figure. If you look at this circuit, they are asking for the equivalent resistance. So you have to use the serial and parallel both the equation. First you look at here, this 20 ohm and 20 ohm both are in parallel. So parallel means you have to take R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2, which is given here. So 20 into 20 divided by 20 plus 20, 10. So the value of these two resistor is 10 ohm. If you look at this and this, these two are in serial now. If two resistors are connected in series, then the equivalent resistance will be R1 plus R2. So 10 plus 10, 20 will be the equivalent resistance of this whole and this whole element. So you will be getting 20, because here 10, here 10. So 10 plus 10, 20. Now this 20 and this 20, both are connected in parallel again. Already we have connected 20, 20 parallel means you are getting 10 ohm is the answer. So directly I am writing 10 ohm. So the equivalent resistance of this whole circuit is 10 ohm only. So we will be seeing in the upcoming video of Ohm's law and the Kirchhoff's law. Thank you.